Bluetooth is a standard and communications protocol primarily designed for low power consumption with a short range based on low-cost transceiver microchips in each device. Bluetooth makes it possible for these devices to communicate with each other when they are in range. Because the devices use a radio communication system, they do not have to be in line of sight of each other. To support development of Bluetooth-enabled software on the Java platform, the Java community process, that is JCP, has defined JSR82. The Java APIs for Bluetooth wireless technology, that is JABWT. JSR82 actually specifies two independent optional packages, that is the Core Bluetooth APIs and the Object Exchange OBEX APIs. The more prevalent is the Core Bluetooth package java.bluetooth. This picture shows the Bluetooth protocol stack. JSR82 exposes the Bluetooth software stack to developers working on Java platform. Of special interest are the Service Discovery Protocol, that is SDP, the Serial Port Profile, RFCOMM, for serial emulation, and the Logical Link Control and Adaption Profile, which provides the connection-oriented data services to upper-layer protocols such as segmentation and reassembly operation and protocol multiplexing. JABWT also includes the Object Exchange APIs. On Bluetooth, object exchange occurs over RFCOMM. This is a diagrammatic representation of the elements of a Bluetooth-enabled applications. This picture shows how each and every Java classes are connected to the My Bluetooth Midlet application and also their relationships. Let's move to the other slide. This is a diagrammatic representation of how Discovery Agent and Discovery Listener is connected through the Bluetooth client application. Bluetooth is a technology which is available on most of newer mobile phones. Early generation mobile phones are not comprised with like these technologies. Java facilitates the developers to invent sophisticated technologies like Bluetooth to cater the customers. Some other mobile applications are Audio Tuner Mobile V1.3 J2ME, Digital Tablish 3.0, Magi Player Media Player for mobile phones, Twim V1.5, and Talking Clock 1.0, and final one is J2ME DIT V1.0. When we consider Audio Tuner Mobile V1.3 J2ME, it keeps your musical instrument in tune with Audio Tuner Mobile. Tune musical instruments using your mobile phone. This includes guitar, violin, piano, bass guitar, banjo, mandolin and cello. Magi Player is a media player providing a rich user experience on multiple devices. It includes video, playback and music, for example MP3 support. Magi Player allows you to organize and browse your media on your cell phones, create playlists and listen or view the media using an attractive interface. Digital Tablish 3.0. This application is designed for using your mobile phone as Tablish and torch. You can define your own stop numbers and save the last counted number to load in the future. This application also can be used as a manual counter. Twim V1.5. Twim is a mobile Twitter client. You can browse history, replies, friends and public feeds with the application. User can also update his or her status. Application requires Java MIDP 2.0 enabled mobile phone and it requires an internet connection for reading your timeline, entries and updating your status. Talking Clock 1.0. Simple talking clock written in Java for mobile phone J2ME compliant. All these are developed using Java language. Let's move to the other slide. This table shows a comparison of two mobile application development technologies, J2ME and Flashlight. Looking at this table, you can easily differentiate both technologies and their relations. In here also shows the main differences between flashlight and J2ME? Throughout this presentation, we have focused on the mobile phone technologies and their evolutions with programming language like Java. First and second generation mobile phones were not so developed due to lack of technology and languages. Java language has done a major contribution to the development of mobile applications. The Java 2 Micro Edition, that is J2ME, which is heavily used in mobile application development. As a conclusion of the presentation, I hope that by listening to this, you gain something about the development of mobile technology based on Java language. These are the references which we have referred. This is our team for PLDC. This is the end of our presentation. Special thank goes to our lecturer in charge, Mr. Lakmal Rupasinghe, and our team members for their contribution in making this presentation in success. Hope you have enjoyed. Thank you.